In just a few minutes, you're going to be asked to create a display that uses a lot of the things that you see here, all these primitives here. What you'll find is that, like any good graphic editor, what we support is, you know, a standard set of objects like this. You know, here's a rectangle. We support an ellipse, which you can, if you hold down the control key, or excuse me, if you hold down the shift key, you can create that as a circle. So the conventions that you may be familiar with, you know, holding down shift to preserve aspect ratio, holding down shift to draw a perfect circle or a perfect square, or letting up on shift to draw a rectangle. All these things are available from within Process Book as a graphic editor. And it's this that we use for building the different things that need to be constructed for your, you know, process graphics. So for example, if I hold down control and I grab this object right here, that will duplicate that object. If I draw a bounding box around all of them, I can then, you know, manipulate them all at once. So for example, fairly easy for me to grab these things, convert them into what I need to use them for. For example, in this case, I want to build a tank. And so I've built that tank out of these three objects. Now, of course, right now, it doesn't quite look like the tank I want it to look like, so I'm going to change the line color so that this looks a little bit more like a tank. I can also go in and group this together, because right now, well, let me show you the before and after. If I have one that's been grouped and one that hasn't, of course, if your users are in build mode, when they try to move something, it's going to fall apart. Let me do a Control Z to undo that. See, now with a grouped object, I can do, I can make it a little bit more flexible, more easy to use. The other nice thing about grouping these objects is then, you know, some of the other things like rotation becomes available. We can rotate these objects. That's something that, you know, basically you'll be able to do that when you are grouping them, but you won't be able to do that if they're not grouped. So it's a good example of some of the features that you'll find in Process Book that are just about the same as any other graphic editor. You know, I can now ungroup this. Ungrouping this now brings it back to its component parts. And like any good Windows application, there are multiple levels of undo. I can do a Control Z to undo these things. Let me go ahead and, now this is grouped back together. So that's supported. You know, all the things that you would expect, supporting text boxes, for example, that's no problem. I can control what the foreground and the background color are using these widgets here. So I'll change the background color to the black, the foreground color to something else. And then if at some point I need to select them and I need to select more than one, if I hold down either Control or Shift, I can select them individually, or excuse me, select them together. I can also use a bounding box to do that. So if you're familiar, real familiar with graphic editors, there's no big surprise to any of this. We do have a symbol library in addition to the things that you could build on your own. So you're not reduced to having to build your own tanks. You can go out to our symbol library and go out and find very nice tanks. And we'll talk a little bit more about that, you know, when we get into our symbol library. So the key takeaway to this particular video is that you will find all the same conventions in play that you'll see with other, you know, with other graphic editors like, or with other graphic editors you may be familiar with. You know, so for example, the convention of sending things to the back or bringing them to the front, all that, you know, works just fine within Process Book. All of that should be real familiar with anybody who's worked within other graphic editors.